Well, if it isn't beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Christmas sucks. I hate it.
Everywhere, Scrooge is getting worse.
If you're looking to get out of that Grinch spirit, Apple Plus is a new Christmas musical with everyone's favorite elf and dead guy. Spirited is a take on the Charles Dickens classic, A Christmas Carol, and in this video we're going to be taking a deep dive into the story and if it's a contender for a holiday classic. But before we do, make sure to like and subscribe or my children are getting lumps of coal for Christmas. While the main story seems to revolve around a man visited by the ghost of Christmas past, present, and future, Spirited is really about our ability to change. In fact, the whole Department of Spirits runs on the idea that people can. In the movie's opening scene, we meet the latest case, that of Karen Blanksy, a disgruntled Scrooge of a woman who hates everyone on her street. But by showing her the error of her ways, the spirits are able to turn her life around and make her a beloved member of the community. But are there people who are too far gone as to not be saved? Are there some who are unredeemable? That's the main question at the core of Spirited's story. With the successful change of Karen, no doubt a name given because of its association with these, the spirits begin their work finding next year's case. They'll have a full year to prepare everything they need in order to change what they call their perpetrator. But one of the biggest tasks is choosing the right candidate. They need someone who can cast ripples, meaning when they change, that change will impact hundreds of others. But before we get there, we need to meet one of our main characters, the Ghost of Christmas Present. I'll just call him Present for now. He's held the position for 46 years, and as he strolls through the Hall of the Redeemed, a place where he can see all the people he saved, including Dolly Parton, we get what's called our I Want song, a song in which the character sings to us their wants, dreams, and aspirations. In it, Present dreams of buying a house, meeting a nice girl, and maybe even kissing one.
One of those newfangled modern mouth kisses.
But something is holding him back from achieving this. Yes, he's technically dead, but as part of his retirement plan, he'll be able to go back to Earth and live out the rest of his life as a mortal. So why is it then that he's too afraid to retire? We'll get to that in a bit. The search for next year's candidate leads them to a stuck-up hotel owner whose ripple effect could change the lives of the hotel's hundreds of employees. But while staking out their new target, Present finds a candidate far more thrilling. Meet Clint Briggs, president of a PR firm that deals in lies, fake scandals, and misinformation. Whereas Present believes people can change, Clint believes they can't.
Have people changed?
Now that's the good news. Now people never change.
He breaks out into a whole song and dance about how the key to success is feeding the hate. He's a man who will do anything and everything to win, regardless of the outcome. Present pleads to his boss Jacob to choose Clint as their next target. Just think of the ripple effect changing him would have on thousands of people. For those of you familiar with A Christmas Carol, you'll know that Jacob Marley was the name of the spirit who visits Ebenezer Scrooge to warn him that he'll be visited by three ghosts. Jacob was Scrooge's longtime business partner and died 7 years prior to the events of the book. Jacob tells everyone that Clint is a lost cause, that he's unredeemable, but Present won't give up.
Besides, you know it's been done before.
Once. Barely.
If you caught this line earlier in the movie, it foreshadows the film's big reveal, that the Ghost of Christmas Present is Ebenezer Scrooge himself. He wants to take Clint on to prove that an unredeemable, like he was, can be saved, and he so believes he can change Clint he threatens to retire if the boss doesn't let him. Jacob relents and their year of preparation begins, in a really nice quick montage no less. As we catch up to Clint a year later, we see he's the same old asshole, initially declining to help his own niece, Wren, win her school student council presidency. Of course, Clint's tactics aren't the most savory. He'll get his executive vice president, Kimberly, to dig up dirt on Wren's opponent, but this type of mean-spiritedness isn't what Wren had in mind when she asked for help. As we'll see later on in the story, it'll have disastrous ripple effects on others. Kimberly finds that Josh Hubbins, Wren's opponent, deleted a damning TikTok 2 years ago. But is she really the type of person to be destroying kids' lives?
That's official. I'm a terrible person.
If Kimberly is going to change as a person, she needs to find the courage to do what is right. So already we can see how multiple characters in this story are wrapped up into the theme of change. On Christmas Eve, Clint's journey with the spirits begins, first being visited by Jacob, who warns him of the three spirits, and then by the Ghost of Christmas Past. There's just one snag. Christmas Past has a bit of a crush on Clint, and the two do a little bit more than just make out under the mistletoe, leaving Present with doing her task and taking Clint into the past. It's here we see how Clint's alcoholic and manipulative mother tricked him into thinking he was getting a puppy for Christmas, and conversely how caring and loving his sister Carrie was. Maybe that's why she's called Carrie. Present had hoped this memory from the past would make Clint see the key events that shaped him, but Clint fires back saying his mom's trick was the best Christmas present ever.
The solid gold lesson that people will believe anything if they want to believe it.
And that gets at the core of Clint's character. He has to believe that people can't change because it gives him an excuse to be the asshole that he is. That's just the way he is, he can't change it, c'est la vie. We'll later see him with Nora, the girl who got away, and she says to him,
I thought that I could change you, and only a fool would think that.
We'll see Clint working as the new guy at a company where Kimberly also works, and later he'll use his deceitful tactics in order to impress his boss. But those tactics do the opposite. That's not the way to conduct business, and he's fired, eventually hiring Kimberly and starting his own business, Briggs Media Group, which has no qualms with creating controversy, conflict, and spreading disinformation. Clint's past also shows how unkind he is toward his sister, telling her that she isn't ready to be a mom when she tells the family she's going to a fertility clinic. But the most stressing scene from Clint's past is one he runs away from, a scene we'll later see in its entirety when his dying sister asks him to be the one to look after her daughter when she dies. Instead of agreeing to it, he shuns her. His selfishness is too much. This turns out to be one of his biggest regrets. Present calls this memory a kicker, one that needs to be faced in order to affect any real change. While running from his past, Clint escapes into the spirit's workplace where he finds the file on him saying unredeemable. In order to win Clint back, Present reveals that he too was once unredeemable. That he was once Ebenezer Scrooge, the man A Christmas Carol was based on. If he can change, so can Clint. They travel back in time, briefly meeting Judi Dench before starting an all-out brawl with the townspeople, and they're transported back to present day. Here, Clint gets to see how his co-workers truly feel about him, and it's not that great. Present even gets him to visit Nora, who lives with a loving family. And after Clint finally confronts his dying sister in the past, the ghost of Christmas Present's job is now over. Clint still has one more spirit to visit him, but now it's time for Present to decide if he's going to retire. And he does, waking up right alongside Clint as a mortal.
Look out, New York City! This guy showers once a month!
Present now has the chance to make a move on his crush, Kimberly. She was previously able to see him, even though he was a ghost, because deep down Present wanted her to see him. Falling in love with Kimberly is part of his journey in becoming a better man, stepping away from Scrooge and reaffirming his commitment to change. Part of the reason he never retired was that he was so afraid if he went back to Earth he'd experience what he called a Scrooge deja vu. He'd turn back into the evil man he once was. This is why changing Clint was so important to him.
I thought, if I can change this guy, maybe there's hope for me too.
Bonus points if you got the man in the elf costume.
He looks stupid.
Clint's visit from the ghost of Christmas's future starts off well, but quickly takes a dive. Ren wins the school's presidency, but Josh has killed himself as a result of her posting that video of him. Clint's actions have now rippled negatively to those around him, and he's seeing this firsthand. There's a very brief shot of him dying at his desk at the age of 93 before he's thrust back into present day by the ghost of Christmas future. He knows he doesn't have much time to stop Ren from posting that video. He and Present make their way to the ice rink where they're too late, or at least that's what they think. While they were gone, Kimberly found the courage to do what was right and tells Ren not to post the video. Present is ecstatic that Clint went out of his way to stop his niece from posting that video. It really shows that he has changed, but he's wondering why there isn't a big dance number and celebration for this victory. That's because, as Clint reiterates,
people don't change.
Change isn't something that happens like the flip of a switch. It takes time, and in a few weeks he'll just go back to being the same asshole Clint that he's always been. Even though throughout this journey Present and Clint became bros, this experiment was a failure. So Present decides to jump in front of a bus, hoping it will take him back to the spirit world where he can resume his job. But Clint pushes him out of the way to save his life and does his first truly selfless act. He put someone else before himself. This was the final thing needed for Clint to truly change. And as everyone indulges in a big song and dance, they're thrust back into reality when Clint is actually hit by the bus and killed. As Jacob says,
"But your sacrifice would have no meaning
if it had no consequence.
Clint gets to meet his dead sister, who beckons him toward the light, but Clint has a better idea. How about he put his elite business skills to the test and become the new Ghost of Christmas Present? With Present now a mortal by the name of Roberto, it's a spot that needs to be filled, and who better than Clint? And this shakeup comes with a bunch of new changes. They'll be taking on multiple cases a year and branching out to include other religions. Very inclusive. His sister has even joined in on the job, and he's now dating the Ghost of Christmas Past. We see that some years have passed since Clint goes on to visit Kimberly and Roberto, who now have two kids, that thing Roberto always dreamed of. We also hear that Ren has gotten into a master's program at Stanford, and Clint even gets Roberto's help with a particularly difficult file. So it looks like people can really change. Clint now does a job that helps others, Roberto has turned into a family man without turning back into Scrooge, and Kimberly found the strength to stand up for what's right. Bonus points if you caught the number 1843 by Kim and Roberto's house, which is the date A Christmas Carol was first published. But I want to hear about what you thought of Spirited. Will you be revisiting this one in years to come, or will it wind up a forgotten stocking stuffer? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, everyone. Be sure to like and subscribe. And for more bad takes, you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at ThinkStoryYT. Until next time, remember,
he's like the perfect combination of Mussolini and Seacrest.